what should be the strategy when you're taking mocks? What should be the plan for VRC? What should be the plan for LRDI? What should be the plan for quant? Should I do RC first or VA first? Should I spend too much time on question selection? Or should I go one thing at a time? How many rounds of questions should I take? That's the kind of thing they're thinking about now. First of all, there is no one size fits all. You need to find a strategy that works for you. Do it for 2-3 mocks, consolidate it. Be comfortable with that. Do a couple of experiments and say, may I try this variant, and then come back to your home base. And I'm going to give an outline of what I like doing. And I'm going to say why that works for me. And so for VRC, it's super clear. It is RCs first, VAs next. For RCs, there's a passage reading time. And even the simplest passage, juiciest passage, is probably going to take 4 to 5 minutes to read. You get 0 marks in those 5 minutes. And then 4 questions you can answer in 1/2 minute each or 1 minute each. So RC, if you draw a graph, for each RC, you spend 4 or 5 minutes getting 0 marks, and then four minutes attempting 4 questions. And so the payoff on a time axis is good, but it's uneven. I don't want to start an RC passage with 10 minutes to go. I want to be finishing my RC thing with 5-6 minutes to go. So I want to start with RC, end with VA. I don't want to start a big chunk too late. In VA, I'm not a big fan of the sentence rearrangement thing. With 5 sentences, there are 120 variants, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I usually am very comfortable getting one link, but after that I start struggling. So if I have time, then I go towards para summary, then come to para sentence rearrangement later on. If I'm hard pressed for time, I gamble a little bit in the VA section with sentence elimination and then see where else I can go. But RC first, that's a golden rule. LRDI is the part where you need to spend slightly more time, be switched on about question selection. You need to know 1 or 2 question types that really work for you. For me, I love anything with mathematics in it. If they say ratio, percentages, if they say systems where prime numbers, composite numbers, that's my territory. Arithmetic progression, geometric progression, where the puzzle has math built into it. What are the chances of this happening? How many variants are possible? So permutation, probability, progressions, prime numbers, composite numbers, ratios, anything like that, I'm jumping. Anything that's a pure DI, where it's a graph and 3 graphs, and I have to find what market share this, I'm jumping. Because I like the number ones, I can switch off, do them on autopilot, punch in with the calculator, get myself recharged and attack the next one. So those two I really like. Beyond this, I like Venn diagram, but sometimes I get carried away and do a stinking Venn diagram set which should have been kept aside. So it's not in my most preferred territory, but it's in the top 3. So if I find those, I'm attacking those. If I find a question in my sweet spot, then I jump in and take it on. I'm going to solve it. I'm going to try that. Then I don't want to spend another 3 minutes seeing everything else. I want to solve this. And then with the confidence of having something in the bag, go to the next one. So my evaluation thing has 2 steps. I keep looking for something that I like. But if I find 1 question that I really like, then I'm jumping in. I'll solve that because I'm going to solve that anyway. I don't need to see question search number 3, 4, 5 before coming back to 2. I'm going to do that. So I'll start with it. So the moment I find something that I like, I'm starting. Then I will evaluate again. But I don't want to see all the sets and then make a decision and go for it. Because one, that takes too much time of the initial part. And I become too vested in my decisions. I look at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2 and 3 are my sweet spots. I start with 2 and I read that. And then halfway through that, I suddenly recognize that 2 is too tough. By now, I spent 8 minutes and attempted 0 questions. My heart doesn't want to let 2 go and I get into trouble. Which is why when I like a set, I jump in and start doing. Quant for me, it is see ball, hit ball. I like it in my sweet spot topics. I don't like speed, time, distance. I don't like some trickier, crankier, heavily algebraic questions. So I'll leave these straight away. Too many X's and Y's, I'll leave them. Speed, time, distance, I'll leave them. Everything else, if it appeals to me straight away, I'll have a crack at it. But quant, I have a bias. I feel that I have a compelling advantage. I'm always looking to attempt 24 out of 26 or 23 out of 26. So probably, if you're not saying you have a complete handle on quant, you need to have a slightly different strategy. What might work? For quant, you simply cannot say, look at everything and then select. For LRDI, maybe that'll work. For quant, you cannot say, I'll do only topics from very specific questions and then come back. It doesn't work like that. Simple rule of thumb, if you have a set of sweet spot topics, then keep hitting those. Leave very early. If you have a slightest ambiguity, leave. And then you finish one round, you go to the end of final question. If you've done everything in your sweet spot range and that attempts that amounts to about 12, 13 questions out of 25 or 26, then you're good. If you have reached this at the 25 minute mark, brilliant. Now it's your chance to go and kill this. If you have reached this in the 37 minute mark, that means this was a tough paper, but at least you've done all your good questions. Your speed of the first round cannot be so bad that you don't even see all questions. It can be so good that you finish off and then have one more round. You should do at least one round. So do the pace setting. If your pace is so slow that you won't even reach till the last question, then you need to skip more with more abandon and so with joy. But if you're doing slightly faster, then it's okay. Keep doing. And you have 10 minutes more remaining, then come back. One thing I love doing in quant is I'll earmark questions straight away. I'll write question number straight away that I'm going to come back to. And so with 3 minutes to go, very often it happens in quant that with 3 minutes to go, you've done one round, one and a half rounds, and then you're ready. And then you're scrambling, looking for questions and saying, which one will work? That will work. GCC, which is difficult. I will go back to question number 11, then 14, then 17 if I have time. I'm going just to that question. I'm not re-evaluating 11, 14, 17. I've just written down three numbers. I'll go there. Even if 11 is slightly worse compared to 14 for attempt, I'm all right. But I'll go to 11, try to solve it. I'm not again taking a set of decisions. So I'll mark down questions that I'm coming back to in case I'm in a last minute scramble. That might help. Keep your wits with you. Keep your energy levels with you. Drink plenty of fat water. Stay healthy. Best wishes for CAT.